Prayer is what the whole world needs. Prayer is a key to the kingdom. Prayer will give ease to troubled minds. I remember reading the Bible the other day when Jesus told his disciples, said, "Watch with me while I pray." Oh Lord, prayer been around a long time. Prayer is a strong weapon. Oh Lord, that was a young man that believed in prayer. When he found the need to pray, he didn't care where it was, he would go down on his knees. One day, the young man was in the cornfield. He found the need to go down on his knees. While he was on his knees, the overseer came and said, "I don't mind you praying, but when you pray, pray on your own time." Oh Lord, Lord, that next morning, the young man was on his way to the front yard. When he made it to the front yard, he felt the need to go down on his knees. Oh Lord, while he was on his knees, the overseer came up and said, "I told you, when you pray, to pray on your own time." Oh Lord, he pipped him till his clothes had clung to his back. Yes, he said, "I wonder, would you remember?"
A sacrifice, if you will. So I cut a deal with a pin and a blade, made a trade, my blood for that ink, cause I don't think too many people are in the blade for the thing. To be cut open for the craft they love, for God so loved the world he crafted, that he gave his only begotten son, named my God's child. And it's only natural for me to take a latitude. My latitude might be more south than you, but it's cool, because where I'm from, we used to swangin' and banging from the bottom. You want some bars and art, I got a passion on, I got a Vittorio. Nah, you toss me the alley, I'm breaking the backboard. You wanna run the floor? First you gonna run through me. Sorry, I believe that greatness is everyone you see. But on this particular mic, you just gonna have to outgrate me. Sorry, if I don't make it easy. Every more claw and fangs and roots and violence, I seem a bit more violent than what you used to. Again, let me remind you, they called me here because they said they needed some blood on the mic. Translation, someone's gotta pay the price. Translation, art comes at a cost, and I ain't talking to anything in thoughts. I'm talking revelation that changed the heart. And for that to happen, somebody gotta be set apart. See, that's why I come in, because the sacrifice must be without spot or blemish. The sacrifice must be a closest thing to a perfect pin. The sacrifice must be a ten. Now, I'm no Christ, but if you need someone nailed to this mic and bound, someone to christen this platform in the holy ground, I'll lay down this crown in this stage with an altar, offer myself as a living artist, both dope and phenomenal. See, I've been set ablaze so many times, they can't tell the difference between the fire and my shine. They say the sacrificial poet got to judge you, put a snake on the line, and that's fine. But while I'm here, I'ma test your spine, see if you aligned or lost, if you more grit or gloss. I ain't here to just set a tone, I'm trying to raise the bar with the bar. Took myself in the chamber, show you what a shooting star can do, cause ain't nobody here to spar with you. Ain't no throwing hands at a gun show, you only guaranteed one shot. Better make sure every time you pull, it's a headshot. No deadlock on the shot clock, you got 3 minutes on the stopwatch. So make every word count, talk to the metaphor like you met before. Fix the imagery, the clear obscenity with the simile. Use the hyperbole to tell your story. Be a little glory, there is glory after this. And as for the artists.
When the steel blue ghost standing at the podium says, Mondarrat Myers was no angel, all I can hear is, the boy was a human boy. The boy had a best friend in 206 bones. The boy had a name that God didn't give him. When he died, he did not bleed starlight or gold. He was not half bird. The gun spoke, and no flaxen wing shot from each shoulder, as if to carry him beyond the bullet's swift assignment. No, the boy was not a pillar of white smoke, bright enough to break a non-believer, make a holy man fall prostrate, heaving, heavy with contrition. But let me be clear. They are simply running out of ways to shame our dead. How else to say that they are guilty and yet unburied? How else to erase him if they cannot feign omnipotence, lay claim to the sky, colonize heaven, take aim at the boy just one more time while everyone watches too? So when I say, I do not believe in hell, but there are nonetheless men, dead and living, I wish hell upon. Understand, I am first a historian of suffering. That James Baldwin sang The Fire Next Time in 1963, and we are living in the wake of his impossible love. I too dream of such heat. Pray for flame with the diligence of a saint, scarlet tongues of light, sharp enough to cut bone and soul just the same. My parents praise a vengeful God. Son of all three, what else could I inherit but this commitment to the scales? That killer woke up today. Probably ate scrambled eggs for breakfast. Brushed his teeth three times or fewer. Walked in soft slippers through the living room today. Checked the mail while a child decomposed underground. Held still beneath the bloodless weight of the law. I yearn for nothing if not equilibrium. A means to honor how my elders taught me to pray. Lord, if you be at all,
Thank you. slide.